long time ago, a giant space rock slammed into what is now Greenland. If you're wondering why you haven't heard of this massive meteorite crash, that's because for millennia, evidence of the impact was hidden beneath the ice of Hiawatha Glacier in northwest Greenland. Until now. Recently, aerial radar surveys revealed a depression under 930 meters of ice, and now an image of the meteorite impact has taken shape. At 31 kilometers across and about 320 meters deep, the hole rivals the size of cities like Washington, D.C. and Paris. Researchers put it among the 25 largest impact craters on Earth. The space rock was probably a rare iron asteroid. To leave such a dent in Earth's crust, it had to be roughly 1.5 kilometers wide. And when the asteroid hit, it vaporized up to 20 cubic kilometers of rock. That's enough rock to fill 15,000 astrodomes. Other signs of the fiery fallout persist in the landscape. Quartz crystals and sediment from a nearby river showed deformities typical of a space rock collision. The impact sent molten bits of rock from Earth into the air, and glassy grains in the same sediment may even be some of that flash-melted debris. The big question is, exactly how old is the crater? It's probably no older than the ice sheet. That formed at the beginning of the Pleistocene. So the crater is probably somewhere between 2.6 million and 11,700 years old. But only further studies can confirm and narrow that range. A lot rides on the age of the crater. There's a fierce debate over something called the Younger Dryas. That's the technical name for a chilly period that began about 12,800 years ago. But we don't know exactly what triggered the deep freeze. If the age of the Hiawatha crater matches up, it could bolster a controversial hypothesis that a space rock caused the thousand-year cold snap.